have the biggest overlap for possible ones that share the same name.
So we link them basically use the name usage, but the name usage is from reference that if you see the taxonomy treatments in the literature, they usually put the accepting name on, and the not accepting name below. Right. Yeah. So we use this name usage, we link them together. So but they are all based on the reference.
Yeah.
And also link by the basal name. If they got basal name or original combination, they can group them together.
Thank you. So next one is improved sharing and linkage of taxonomic data with taxon concept standards, TCS.
I think next conference we need to order the talks by height of the speaker. Thank you. Well, for me, everything is fine. I'm 35 now, but good afternoon. My name is Niels Klaziger. That's better. I'll start over. Good afternoon. My name is Niels Klaziger from the Royal Botanic Gardens, Victoria. It's over the Bass Strait in Melbourne, and also from the Atlas of Living Australia. I'm also the chair of the TEDWIC Taxon Concept Schema Maintenance Group and of the TCS2 task group, and which is the hat I'm wearing now, and that's what the talk will be about. Sounds like I often start to speak a lot louder. Next talk, before I get down to business, I'd like to acknowledge the traditional owners of the country where we meet, the Muwinina people, and recognize Aboriginal people's continued connection to land, sea, waterways, sky, and culture. I'll pay my respects to elders past and present. TCS, or the taxonomic taxon concept schema, is a TEDWIC standard for pushing around taxonomic data. It's one of the 2005 group of standards together with ABCD and STD, which are based on XML schema. And the job of the TCS two task group and the TCS maintenance group, that's the first job of the TCS maintenance group, is to get TCS in a form that it can be maintained according to the vocabulary maintenance standard. And that's what we have been doing over the last 2.5 or 3 years. That's our task. Take TCS out of its XML schema, bring it into a state where it can be managed under the vocabulary management schema. For this particular task, only the structure is in scope, not the meaning, so we're not going at anything significant change in any whole new terms and things related to the structure. We stay as close to TCS1 as possible, and the reason behind that is that this subject, we focus on very strong and disparate opinions, and under the vocabulary maintenance schema, maintenance standard, this is bad. We need to change to the standard. It needs to have consensus among the community, and so we basically give the people as little as possible that they can disagree with, because without disagreeing what's already the standard. And the thing with these XMLs, and these terms seem all very intuitive, so hardly any of them have definitions, and that's what we'll provide. So why are we doing it, and why don't we just stick with Diamond Core, because the Diamond Core has a text on core. Well, the text on core works really well with collection data and survey data and occurrence data, but it's not ideal to exchange taxonomic data. Yeah, taxonomists like myself, they can do everything they need to do with Darwin Core taxon, but it doesn't exactly promote best practice, because it's a bit too lenient. It doesn't give you too much guidance about how things should be ended. And so one of the bit, it was actually quite put most succinctly in the RDF guide for Diamond RDF guide for Diamond Core. So they couldn't actually do anything with the Diamond Core taxon class in RDF, because it has references to all these classes that don't exist in Diamond Core, and also it's not clear what the relationships are between taxon concepts, taxon name usage, and taxon name usage, and it's not actually clear what the Diamond Core taxon is. So talking about the definition we spend most time on, of course, is the definition. What's the taxon concept? So these are some of the definitions. There's actually no definition in TCS itself. The top one comes from the TCS user guide. Taxon concept, name plus a description. The second one is from an important article that was written by Nico Franz and Robert Peet that actually pretty much presented TCS to a taxonomic audience. I'm not going to read it out. You'll read it by now. And the third one is from the UBio website. It's a taxon concept, defines what a name actually means. So taxon is about semantics. And I had to be difficult. I don't like to be the I didn't want a name in there, because I don't think it's a good idea to define concept by the labels. So this is what Nico came up with for us. So it's an identifiable taxonomic position. Nico doesn't like to use the word taxon. That can be aligned to other such positions to TCS taxon concept mapping relationships. The two important words in here are identifiable. It has to be identifiable. If you're just a name, it's not identifiable, because a name can apply to multiple taxon concepts. You need to have a reference or source or an according to with that. And the other one is that it has to be alignable, so that you can need to have enough context so that you can align it with other taxon concepts. So this is what I've come up with. This is pretty much all our terms. Not pretty much, it is all our terms. So basically we've got two main classes, taxon concept, taxon name. And then we had the one in the middle, in the dark red, that says nomenclatural type. That is something we added that is pretty much partly TCS, partly in Diamond Core, so we can actually use it with Diamond Core as well. So it links to the name, of course, and then it links into a specimen. I put here the preserved specimen in, but in examples, I've also been using material citation. So it links to a specimen that can be recorded in Diamond Core. And yeah, you can use the type status property in Dynamo IR for that. So I'll go skip through that. So the link below here, that's actually the term list that we have. And the term list is ready. I'd hope to have the TCS in public review by this conference, but didn't quite make it. So, but by the end of the year, we hope we get there. So how well does it... Ah, TCS hangs completely together with from relationship, as you could see from all the errors, in the thing, not all the errors. So there's three types of relationships within TCS. So relationship between taxa, relationship between taxa and names, and relationship between names. I'm going to watch the time and skip through this as well. So we compared it with the open biodiff ontology, which is an ontology for the domain, which was the publication came out right just before we started in 2018. It's a very important ontology for our domain, and it's a very good it's a very good publication. A bit hard to read for people like me. It's completely out of the comfort zone, but so to compare, I have left all the colors the same. So green is taxon concept, red is the name, and blue is the reference. And so it accords very well. And the next one is COS, which I think is also important. So that works very well as well. And I think accordance with the open biodiff ontology is important because, well, you know, that's the ontology for our domain, and SCOS is also very important because that's much better understood by non-taxonomists, by developers and data people, they would understand SCOS much better than taxonomy. So if we can map our terms roughly against SCOS, then that is good. So I did it in the next slide. Works very, 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 very well. TCS, of course, much more detailed. And yeah. So I know if we go back to the relationship, you see SCOS has this super property. So for the relationship between taxon, so the horizontal relationship, so the mapping relationship in SCOS, you've got, this last slide. You've got this the super property mapping relation that covers all the horizontal relationships. And they also have a super property semantic relationship, which includes broader SCOS broader, which is the same as SCOS parent. So the semantic relationships include all the relationships between taxa, the relationship between names or label relation, that's also super property in SCOS, and the relationships between taxon concept and names. And taxon names, there's not a super property for, but those are all the pref label, alt label, and hidden label ones. And so now to my acknowledgements, members of the maintenance group and members of the task group, we have had a lot of very enjoyable discussions. It's Rich said it enough. I have a theory because it's too much fun to keep discussing it. That's me.
I think our next presentation is recorded, so we have time for one quick question.